This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to solve this right triangle that we see right here. So remember, to solve the right triangle, it means we need to know all three angles and all three sides. So the angles are A, B, and C. And the sides are lowercase a, means it's the side opposite the angle A, and lowercase b and lowercase c. C is the hypotenuse because it's opposite the right angle. Right, so first of all, let's write down what we do know. We don't know angle A and we don't know angle B, so we can't fill anything in here, but we know angle C is the 90 degree angle. All right, do we know side A? Now the side A is the side opposite angle A, and yes we do, that is 4.1. Do we know the side opposite angle B? That's given, is 6.2. And you don't see the decimal point there, but 6.2. And how about side C? No. Remember, to solve a right triangle, first of all, you have to have a right angle, so you're always going to know the right angle, right? And then you have to have at least one side. So in this problem, we are given two sides. We don't know either angles this time. I can find the third side anytime you have two sides. One way to find the third side is just to use the Pythagorean theorem. So remember, if you want to know the hypotenuse, which is c squared is the lengths of the legs squared and added together. So it's 6.2 squared plus 4.1 squared. And so c will just be the square root of all that. So just keep in mind that if you wanted to know what c was, you would just take the square root of it, and that's what you want to just put in your calculator. That would be the exact answer, whatever you get. And what we'll do is round to the nearest tenth. So in your calculator, you want to compute the square root of 6.2 squared plus 4.1 squared. And when I do that, I get 7.4. Now notice this is not exact, it's rounded, okay? So this is 7.4. First of all, it should be longer than either of the two sides, and it is. So that seems like a reasonable answer. So we've got 7.4. Now, so we've got C figured out. But I want to use some of the original information to figure out A or B. Be careful. You don't want to use something that you've rounded to find out something else, because you're going to get off. You're going to have an error. So if you had left whatever this was exact, you could use it. But if I rounded it, I don't want to use the 7.4. So I'm going to try to figure out how to find angle A or angle B using these two sides. So let's say I wanted to figure out what angle A is, and I wanted to use these two sides. What I'm looking at, in, you know, from A is the side opposite and the side adjacent. So you think, what trig function use the side opposite and the side adjacent? And that would be the tangent. So the tangent of A would be the side opposite, 4.1 over 6.2. Now we don't want to compute that yet. That'll tell us what the tangent of A is. Now if the tangent of A is that, here's where you have to remember your inverse functions. That means that if the A is just the inverse tangent of that. So the inverse tangent of 4.1 over 6.2. You want to keep everything exact before you plug it into your calculator. This will give us an angle A. And if you want it in degrees, make sure that you've got your calculator set up in the degree mode. All right, so now in your calculator, we're going to plug in the tan inverse, and then in parentheses, 4.1 divided by 6.2. And let's round to the nearest tenth of a degree. So you want to put it in degree mode. All right, when I do that, I get that it's approximately 33.5 degrees. So for A up here, I have 33.5 degrees. All right, now I know that A and B have to add up to 90 degrees. So I just do 90 minus 33.5, and now I'm going to get B, 56.5. You don't have to worry about starting over and finding out B. You could do B by using the tangent as well. You could say, by the way, let's say somebody wanted to do that. Let's just go ahead and see how that would have worked. I know that the tangent of B would be its opposite, which is 6.2 over 4.1. So if I wanted to know what B is, I would do the tan inverse of 6.2 over 4.1. So go ahead and put that in your calculator. The tan inverse of 6.2 over 4.1. And hopefully when you rounded that, you did get 56.5 degrees. All right? So maybe somebody found out what B was, and then they figured out A would be the 33.5. So now let's look. Now we've solved our triangle. We know all three angles. We know all three sides. Let me see if this makes sense. Does that look, you know, approximately correct? Is like A, that looks like the smaller angle, 33.5, and it's across from the smaller side. B, the medium size angle, is across from the medium side. And C, the right angle, which is the biggest angle, is across from the largest side, the hypotenuse. And if you want, you could go ahead and do the Pythagorean theorem again, but of course that's how we found C in the first place. So you can make sure that 6.2 squared plus 4.1 squared is approximately the same as 7.4 squared. All right, so that's our second problem, solving a right triangle, this time knowing two sides, knowing two legs of a triangle. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.